oxytocin we usually talk about when there's some oxytocin. Basically, as you had said earlier also, why the gynec is getting involved. So it's right from the beginning, the hormone balance should be maintained well. So it's if the hormone level is fine, well, only then will it help for the milk production. Everything in general, the hormone balance is the one which is very important for a patient. And for that, the emotional balance in a mother. Many of the times after delivery, there is some anxiety in the patient and the mother hormones start fluctuating, which in a way results for the milk production. Secondly, it is always said that once the baby is delivered, the baby when kept closer to mom is always what is appreciated and is always suggested. Many a times it does happen that the parents, maybe the grandparents sit with the babies aside and the mother is taking some rest. Rest is definitely important for the mother, but the baby along sitting with the mother will help stimulate the milk production. So this is how it will help for milk production.
Now I would like to ask, which factors affect the oxytocin reflex, ma'am, to you?
Preparation is going on throughout the pregnancy for the breastfeeding, for the lactation. What happens when patient goes into labor and once the baby delivered and after that the placenta comes out and during that and immediately after the delivery of the baby, we give the baby to the mother. Baby starts suckling at the nipple. When the baby starts suckling at the nipple, because of the stimulation of the nipple, oxytocin release from the brain. That is the pituitary gland. And which acts on the breast tissue for the release of milk production will increase after the release of the oxytocin hormones. And it acts in the uterus also. So it helps the mother for the milk production and to for the mother also it helps for the to stop the bleeding and to increase the contractions of the uterus.
And it is pretty calorie dense. So God put a system in a way that baby who was into the mother's womb was getting continuous nutrient. From that he comes down to her something nutrition pattern which is called intermittent. Baby will take feed, there are plate period of starvation, then take feed. Feed which we all have, isn't it? So the nutrition, the calories in the colostrum helps in that. Plus, baby was sort of in a spa, contained from everywhere, okay, but nothing was reaching him. Now he is in a dirty environment. Okay, the colostrum, the anti-infective property of colostrum helps in fighting those infections. Third thing, it gives not only the calories, it gives a lot of proteins, sugars, a lot of complex carbohydrates. So it helps in maintaining the baby's initial blood sugar level also. Because baby has to sustain some amount of dehydration immediately after birth. So many physiological standpoint from which it is important. Now the second part, how to do it when it is in cesarean section or non delivery or something. It is more or less a mental block, very frankly. Like when I had joined this hospital, there are a couple of gynecologists who will say, Sameer, pehle 24 ghante mein bolne ka nahi. Mother will sleep, usko pain hota hai, mujhe raat ko phone nahi aana chahiye. Okay.
Even my doctor,
it took me so many years to convince and the support of people like Mangla ma'am, sir, ma'am, that now we can initiate breastfeeding within 1 hour. Okay, the mothers who are, unless until they are in general anesthesia or some complication which requires an ICU care, babies want to breast within 1 hour. So it can be done, provided you are geared for it. Second thing, the training of the staff and the motivation of staff, all our maternity and pediatric staff, neonatology staff, the staff has undergone a breastfeeding training certification course. So they all are geared up so that whenever the mother wants to initiate a breastfeeding, done with it.
As ma'am has rightly said, that I strongly believe that mother milk is for the kids. So we can't give a mother milk to the cow's baby. In the same way, we can't give the cow milk to our baby because their chemicals are different, body reactions are different to each and everything. So that's what I strongly believe.
Great, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Next 24 hours.
The thing is, when I had this problem, as I told, my younger daughter was allergic to milk. So I was being told by gynec pediatric, that you can express the milk and keep it in the freezer for 6 months. Is it true? I mean, I'm still not very clear about it.
Ma'am, depends upon how you are storing it.
How you are storing it.
Like so the freezer, the upper part where it gets iced.
In the freezer, you can keep it there.
It refrigerator where the temperature can go to. In those ice cream wallahs who have this. So those are ILRs.
Yeah.
So that kind of medical ILRs are there with the temperature servo control. So if you have to maintain them less than 8 degrees, minus 8 degrees, okay, it can be stored up to 3 months.
Now she was a forceps delivery because her shoulders were pretty broad. So while pulling her out with the forceps, she had got all the scars on her face. So I was like really worried that, you know, there is major scar and she was like pretty fair and that used to look really, you know, being a mother and first time mother was like a crazy thing to see. So whenever I used to ask the pediatric, what should I do, what ointment should I put, so he used to tell me that just put mother milk on it, it will heal. And in 2-3 days, everything was healed and her skin also became very good, you know. And he used to tell me, you also put this on your face, your pigment, because I had lot of skin issues while carrying her. So, he was telling that your skin problem will also heal once you start putting that. So, you already have it, so you are asking me. So, she said, okay, I understand what your mother is doing, that's right, you know. But if you will have this soft and, you know, kind of raw and unspicy food, your kid will get used to that. So, usko baad mein achha khana hazam nahi hoga. So, she told my mother ki isko aap chane wagaira bhi do. So that the baby stomach become used to having all these things also. But little, maybe little more ghee so that it get digested and dissolved. And according what I, when my mother did that also in between, like 41 days ka they have this circle, no? So she gave me chane and all also, but yes, but what I could make out of mother or mother-in-law taking care of your food was taking care of you being a mother, then the kid.
ये इवेंट रचना जी ने ऑर्गेनाइज किया है. उनका ये एक ग्रुप है CVMD विच इज़ ओनली फॉर एक्सक्लूसिव फॉर मदर्स एंड डॉटर्स, केयरिंग एंड वर्सेटाइल मदर एंड डॉटर. सो शी हैज़ इनवाइटेड मी हियर एज अ चीफ गेस्ट एंड दिस इज़ नेम्ड एज स्ट्रेस सेवर एंड दिस इज़ एक्सक्लूसिवली ऑन ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग.
आप खुद एक न्यूट्रिशियन हैं, आप ब्यूटी प्रेजेंट हैं, आप ब्यूटी आइकॉन हैं, आप इसके बारे में क्या नज़रिया है, आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
ये बहुत अच्छा टॉपिक है बिकॉज़ बहुत सारी चीज़ें ऐसी होती हैं फीमेल बहुत स्ट्रगल करती हैं उसको लेके, बट दे नेवर कम आउट विद, यू नो, वो बोलते नहीं हैं, डिस्कस नहीं करते, देर इज़ अ हिच, देर इज़ अ हेजिटेशन दे ऑलवेज फील. सो दिस इज़ अ प्लेटफॉर्म शी क्रिएटेड वेयर यू नो वी कैन टॉक ओपनली एंड डिस्कस द प्रॉब्लम व्हाट वी फेस.
आप काफ़ी समय से इस तरह की सोशल वर्क पर भी लग रही थी, आगे आपका फ्यूचर में क्या प्रोग्राम है?
आगे मैंने जैसे बोला पहले भी बहुत बार बताया कि मेरा एक NGO स्टार्ट किया है जिसका नाम है पंख. सो उसमें मैं उसके लिए काफ़ी सारे इवेंट्स ऑर्गेनाइज कर रही हूँ. वो बच्चों ऐसे बच्चों के लिए हैं जो किड्स हु आर बॉर्न विद स्पेशल नीड्स, आई कॉल देम रेनबो किड्स. सो आई एम डूइंग लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स फॉर टू एम्पावर देम एंड एम्पावर द फैमिलीज ऑल्सो.
थैंक यू.